Hi, my name is Brianna Snyder, and I'm a Board Certified Behavior Analyst with DiNovi & Associates. This video will cover 5th edition task list items F4, F7, and F8. I will be reviewing how to use components of Tyler Fovel's Structured Ecological Assessment tool in a functional behavior assessment. To keep from getting myself tongue-tied and to keep it simple, throughout this video, I will be referring to the Structured Ecological Assessment tool as the STEAT and a functional behavior assessment as an FBA. Any behavior analyst can probably tell you that there are times you walk into an observation for an FBA and you're not exactly sure that this requires setting up functional analysis conditions to run in the classroom with the student. Yes, they might be off task or they're not completely following along with the other students, but is this a skill deficit, a motivational deficit, or is this a behavior that has a longer history of reinforcement at play here? Or you may have at least been able to determine that the target behaviors they are displaying are due to escape from demands. Well, great, you figured out the function, but now what? Or picture this, a school district had the parents sign off on an FBA, but the target behaviors being displayed may be able to be shaped into more appropriate behaviors by pinpointing skills the student needs to acquire in order to access reinforcement in their environment. That could be where the STEAT might come in handy. The STEAT assesses the student's environment and their interactions with the environment across settings. The overall question in an ecological assessment is, what does the student need to do to succeed? This assessment tool can be used for transition between programs, to assess on-task and off-task behavior in relation to the barriers that surround it, and to identify key skills that are reinforced in the target environment so that the student can eventually acquire skills to access reinforcement within that environment. This can help with those students who are perfect in one subject or in one school setting, but might be struggling in other situations or settings. So, how do you use this as part of your observations? The good news is, there are at least a few different ways the STEAT can be used to supplement your FBA, and it includes plenty of data sheets to help with the observation process. Rather than just observing the student, you can observe the setting. When observing the setting, you would focus on the frequency of response opportunities provided by the teacher and the topography of the instructional environment. The components include how the response opportunity is presented, whether it be orally, written, or visually, and the topography of the response expected from students, whether that be oral, written, or another action. Analysis of this data can show what responses are required in the setting and how often response opportunities are provided to the students. Based on this information, the student with which the FBA is being conducted may or may not have the skills required for response expectations. If they do not, interventions can be developed to improve upon those skills. Additionally, you can collect specific data on the student through direct observations. On-task and off-task data can be collected using a 15-second whole interval data sheet. It also describes the type of instruction being provided: presentation, tutorial, self-directed, or a cooperative peer activity. You can also collect data on the rest of the class, allowing for some comparison to take place. The data analysis can show how often your student is on task compared to the norm of the classroom, and which instructional formats with which they engage in off-task behavior. This will allow for you to target increasing on-task behaviors within certain instructional formats. You can also utilize the setting and student skill inventory. This inventory assesses the environment to determine which skills are required, and then based on those skill requirements, determines whether or not the student is able to independently display that skill within the environment. This inventory assesses student placement, instructional formats, the presenter, work performance, visuals, response effort and opportunity, rules and routines, group activities, correction and differentiation, and reinforcement. For example, in math class, a couple requirements are to sit in a chair during a whole group instruction. Your student can sit in a chair, but is not yet able to attend during whole group instruction. That skill deficit would serve as a goal that the behavior analyst can suggest to increase attention during whole group instruction. These are only a few components of the STEAT, so I definitely recommend checking out the assessment in its entirety. Thanks so much for watching. For more content, please visit our channel and subscribe.